Well, he's got one of the biggest fan bases in the sport, and it is easy to see why. Here is the no-nonsense pride of Stockton, California. Proudly repping the 209, here is Nick Diaz. He has fought for UFC championships in the past. Impossibly hard guy to put away. He'll kill you with his boxing, plus jiu-jitsu game as well. Truly a fighter who can do it all, and his fans are some of the most loyal in the game.
Nick Diaz combines attitude with elite cardio, a black belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and outstanding boxing to make for a dangerous combination inside the octagon.
Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, just about ready for live action as we get underway here at Juness Arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. All right, so here is Dustin Poirier as we get ready to go with round one. He says he's doing less sparring at this stage of his UFC career. And
oh, he tagged him in the left. He's got to be careful here. He's clearly in trouble. Very nice. Oh, look at this. Who saw that coming?
Lands a big elbow there.
Big straight punch.
What a fight we got going on here.
He's teeing off with some vicious shots. And he's down.
How about that shin?
Very nice.
Yeah, it looks a little wobbly on his feet.
Oh, he's getting hit. Big shots.
Now a right hand.
Oh, nice hit.
Oh.
There's swung of the haymaker.
Just missed with that straight left hand, Joe.
Oh, man. Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt. Oh, solid jab. Oh, what a leg kick.
All right, so there's a swing and a miss from him, and sometimes when you miss, it can tax your gas tank even more than when you land a strike. So clearly, it is energy preservation time at this point of the fight.
Huge block there.
Well, he got his head snapped back.
Lands a hard shot with the left.
See if he can follow it up.
That one hurt. Perfectly placed strike to end the fight.
Yeah, Joe, beautiful shot to end the fight right there. It couldn't have landed much more flush than it did, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, quite frankly. So near perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight.
There we see it again. And here we see it one more time. Look at the timing in this shot. Boom.
Well, what a moment for him here tonight. A huge knockout on one of the sport's biggest stages. That is one they'll be talking about for some time. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 52 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Nick Diaz.
So congratulations to Nick Diaz. You see, the celebration is on for Cesar Gracie Fight Team. Just absolutely great to see one of the most popular fighters in UFC history back inside the octagon and getting back to doing what he does best. There was a long layoff in advance of this one, but Nick Diaz has proved that ring rust is not a factor for him. A big night here for Stockton, California's finest.
Seconds as a given shit. Every second bitch, I gotta use it. Sign by the fluid and I can't get a microphone and I make them lose it. And I make jump in the back.
Coming up next, it is a heavyweight collision between Kimbo Slice and George Rush St. Pierre.
I'm gonna watch it. Yes, I wanna watch it.
not adjust your sets, ladies and gentlemen. One of the greatest of all time is back. The current UFC middleweight champion, Georges St. Pierre, walked away from the sport after his 12th consecutive win. That was November of 2013. This is a guy that made the takedown in mixed martial arts an art form. Unbelievable what this man accomplished without amateur wrestling credentials. GSP, perhaps the greatest of all time.
The top athletes in the sport. Great speed, great strength, and extremely talented. He's got world-class skills on his feet or on the ground, and he has dominated so many guys with his wrestling.
All right, so here he is, the backyard brawler, the internet sensation, Kimbo Slice, finding his way onto this UFC roster. It was a big win over Houston Alexander that set up this showcase spot for Kimbo here tonight. And when Kimbo's fighting, the masses are tuning in. Let's see what Slice can do with this opportunity here tonight.
This guy has one of the best abilities to take a shot that I have ever seen in all my years of commentating on fights. His chin is truly world class.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. So these fighters relatively close in age, just a year apart, with some differences in height and a similar reach. All right, now for the official introductions, we send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Eve LeVay. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. From the sold-out arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. It's time! 5 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record now. 26 wins, 2 losses.
He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Georges Brush St. Pierre! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 4 wins, 1 loss.
He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 225 pounds. Fighting out of Miami, Florida, Kimbo!
Okay, you can take yourself at all time, obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now, go back to your corner.
I am very fired up for this fight. It's been a long time coming. The fans have been anticipating this for a long time, and it is gonna go down right now.
Well, this is a venue that has hosted so many big UFC fights over the last several years, and we are underway at Juness Arena right here in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Georges St. Pierre.
Oh!
Big left hand!
Defense there, huge block for him. How about that shin? Oh, nice job defensively there to get the guard up. Shot is blocked by GSP.
Blocking all the shots coming towards his head.
Oh, good head movement there. Nice shot.
He's in big, big, big trouble.
Pierre's kick is blocked.
Oh! Wow!
Whoa!
He's badly, badly hurt. This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
He is over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one. That's a big block, Joe.
Oh! Wow!
Big body shot
there, too. Nice leg kick. Another vicious leg kick from St. Pierre.
That is absolutely right, Joe Rogan.
Accurate uppercut that got him the win.
Yeah, Joe, a near-perfect strike to end the fight and end the night for his opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that shot coming. So just the way he drew it up, exactly what he told us during fight week, played out here on fight night. He found a little opening in his opponent's defense and barged right through it to get the big knockout win.
Look at this. Boom! Perfectly placed uppercut.
Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time. The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 23 seconds in the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kimbo!
So Kimbo Slice gets it done tonight. It's amazing to think a few years ago we were watching this guy on the internet brawling in backyards. Since crossing into the Big Show, Kimbo Slice has found a way to get it done, and he gets his hand raised yet again tonight. Coming up next, it's a heavyweight clash between Jorge Masvidal and Nate Diaz. Proudly repping the 209 in Stockton, California. Here is the ubiquitous Nate Diaz, longtime staple of the UFC lightweight and welterweight divisions. He has taken on all comers, realized a lot of success as a 155-pound fighter, had the big win, obviously, over Conor McGregor. Nate Diaz has made a lot of money, and rightfully so. When Nate Diaz makes the walk, the masses are watching.
Nate Diaz has outstanding cardio, a long reach, excellent striking, and a black belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu. This combination of skills has kept him amongst the best in the world.
A pro dating to 2003. Here is the fighter's fighter and UFC welterweight contender, Jorge Gamebred Masvidal, arguably the greatest mixed martial arts athlete the state of Florida has ever produced, a man considered by many to be the best pure boxer on this UFC roster. But let's not denigrate the other parts of his game, Joe. This is a well-rounded five-tool player fighting out of the American Top Team Academy in Coconut Creek, Florida.
This guy has incredible takedown defense. Out of all the fighters in the UFC, he's amongst the most difficult to get to the mat.
Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Masvidal is 1 year the elder. Diaz is 1 inch taller. He will have a 2 inch reach advantage. We send it inside the octagon. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, a referee in charge of the octagon. You ready? You ready?
First round underway.
He hurt him bad. High kick! He hurt him! Oh, what a leg kick.
Oh, heavy leg kick.
Oh, very nice. Fainting.
How about that shin? Well, some have gotten through, Joe. This shot is blocked.
He got tagged there. That one hurt.
Oh, oh, he's had it. Vicious combo there.
He's definitely blocked.
Oh. Oh. Off the jab effectively yet again.
Both men landing in that exchange. Nasty left hook to the body. Big shot to the liver. He buckled.
Combinations here.
He is in big trouble here. He's wincing in pain.
Leg kick check.
He got hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out.
For a knockout blow.
Yeah, there's another one for the highlight reel, Joe, and that's probably as good a knockout as he's had in the UFC. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Crowd absolutely loving it. Flush land to close out his opponent. I'm not even sure the other fighter saw it coming. So a big knockout for him here tonight on the biggest of stages.
Watch this again here. Boom! Out cold.
So there he is after a monumental knockout turned in here tonight. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time. We go to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3:03 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Nate. All right,
so another big win for Nate Diaz here tonight, and I think more importantly, this sets him up for a massive opportunity now moving forward, perhaps even a title shot at 155 pounds. Nate Diaz has made a career of defying the odds, rising to the occasion, and he certainly did that tonight in a matchup that people thought maybe was stacked against him. So congratulations to Nate Diaz. You can be sure they are celebrating in the 209 and beyond after the big win for Nate Diaz here tonight.
Everybody. Put 25 hours out, worked everybody.
Coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Yoel Romero and Israel Adesanya. Get mad when they want to take that knee, but they clap when they can't. Our tale of the day for this, our main event of the evening. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes. Right, we are underway here at Juness Arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. With 11 career wins by knockout, four of those coming.
Oh, he couldn't. He's picking him apart.
Oh, he might be out.
Rocked him with that right hand. Big punches here.
Oh, he blocked that offense, Joe. Nice combination of strikes there by Adesanya.
Doing a good job timing his shot. Oh. Big left hand!
And now a head kick to go.
Nice jab. Hard Superman punch.
Oh, great combination of strikes there. Well, he got cracked to the head there, Joe. He's going to have to change things up here with his footwork. With
oh! 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 Oh!
He's out!
Big spinning back fist for the victory.
Yeah, Joe, just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout.
Let's take a look at it again from a different angle. Look at the power in this right hand as it lands picture-perfect for the knockout. And let's take a look at that from a different angle.
So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory that could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 49 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Yoel Soldier of God Romero.
So Yoel Romero in all his glory is your winner here tonight, and we're getting used to saying that. Olympic silver medalist turned MMA knockout artist, and here he is well past the age of 40, still finding different ways to win inside the octagon. The celebration is officially on for the Soldier of God. Coming up next, a heavyweight collision between Nick Diaz and Kimbo Slice. So here is Kimbo Slice back for more inside a lot of people's expectations. A big win over Houston Alexander, setting up this opportunity for Kimbo. Amidst his second UFC stint, here is the wildly popular 209 rep out of Stockton, California, the Gracie Jiu-Jitsu fighter, Nick Diaz. He has fought and beaten some of the best names in the sport. Idol since 2015 when he fought Anderson Silva. We all look forward to Nick Diaz's return when the world undoubtedly will be watching.
Nick Diaz has some of the best cardio and the best chin the world of mixed martial arts has ever seen. The former Strikeforce champion is still amongst the elite of the elite at 170 pounds.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. So these fighters are just a year apart with similar height and reach.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Well, how good is this? Reminds me of the good old days of Pride, the UFC Grand Prix single night tournament. This has been highly anticipated by fight fans around the world. And remember, if you sustain damage, that could affect you later on in this one night tournament.
He's mixing things up really well, too, from the hands to the kicks to switching stances. So Nick Diaz is landing some very effective leg kicks.
Oh! Big right hand! Huge right hand!
He's in big trouble.
Oh, straight right! Big body shot!
Body.
Oh! Oh, the tackle!
Vicious combinations. He's trying to stay up.
How about that chin?
He's blocking almost all these shots. Oh, he hurt him again. He's got to be careful here.
Joe, huge block there. The defense is holding up.
Oh! Oh, he got hurt! He is hurt! Man!
There is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight.
Let's take a look at that again. Great angle here.
Boom.
Well, what a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. All right, here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 21 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kimbo Slice!
Well, and how about the win there for Kimbo Slice, who does it again against all odds. He defies them and gets his hand raised in the octagon once more. Going to be very interesting to see how they matchmake Kimbo Slice after a monumental victory here tonight.
Took a trip, now we taking sprints. I wasn't made to jog, I'm on ships. Rolling calls a grip, almost major now. Stop, pause, I got hot rods, it could get gangster now. Bang, blow your brains out, see what you thinking about. By associates, I've been scarred.
It's a heavyweight showdown between Nate Diaz and Yoel Romero. So here's the one-time middleweight title challenger and Olympic silver medalist, Yoel Soldier of God Romero. No denying the wrestling credentials, but obviously a guy who has gotten a lot accomplished with his striking and mixed martial arts. 10 career wins by knockout for Yoel Soldier of God Romero, who will be looking for an 11th victim here tonight.
This guy has toughness that you cannot teach. He has an incredible ability to absorb punishment and the mental toughness to come back from devastating situations.
So here's the longtime mixed martial artist, Stockton, California's Nate Diaz, boxing as well. He can take a shot, he can certainly dish one out, he'll lean on the chin as well. And of course, no bigger moment in his career than when he submitted Conor McGregor on less than 2 weeks' notice at UFC 196. Nathan Diaz making the walk once again tonight.
Nate Diaz is a Gracie Jiu-Jitsu fighter with an impressive record of submission victories. He's also got a very active and effective boxing style. Look for him to throw a huge number of strikes while this fight is on the feet.
Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Romero is 8 years his senior. Diaz will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And now with the fighting out of the southpaw stance. So here is the boxer, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, Nate Diaz, making another UFC start tonight. And this is a hard guy to get out of there. Without a 2x4 or some sort of weapon, it's going to take a very special performance to try to finish Nate Diaz tonight. Romero gets caught with that punch.
They're going after it quick here.
All right, so here we go with round one. There is no denying just how much power this fighter has in his kick. So let's see how early he chooses to attack with it. Does he go low to the leg? Does he go high to the leg?